I had met with the Gurdjieff teaching when I was a graduate student at Yale, and I even was studying it personally, but I didn't stay with it. And so I had some years I had was away from it. And he came up to me and he put the book in my, he asked me if I wanted to read this book. It was called Our Life with Mr. Gurdjieff by Thomas de Hartmann. I said, well, I know all of, I had myself the feeling of, I was tempted to say I know all about it, you know, and I was no longer involved with it. But he was so earnest that I took it home, and it sat on my desk for a couple of weeks, and I picked it up one night, and I was deeply touched by it, and I started realizing there was something in this teaching that I hadn't seen, and that became a very important part of my life.
How did you pursue it from there?
Well, it was this young man who presented it to me was part of a community of people who were studying that teaching. Mm-hmm. Under the guidance of someone who had been a pupil of Gurdjieff, a man named John Pentland. And I started getting interested in meeting these people. And after some months of meeting with some of them to talk about it, not wanting to rush into anything, I had the chance to meet this man. And in his presence, I realized this was a man of great authenticity and inner force and understanding.
How did it feel to be in his presence?
Intensely alive, with a kind of sense of another level of human perception, a kind of what someone once called a little bit of a sacred fear. I didn't know what. I certainly wasn't afraid of anything ordinary. But maybe, looking back, I was maybe a little bit afraid that I would lose my ordinary sense of identity in a way. I don't know what it was. But a sense of, a deep sense of homecoming. That this is perhaps what I've been looking for all my life, and without knowing it.
And how did you feel about the other people in the group as they related to each other and as they related to Mr. Pentland?
They all had a deep respect for him without being slavish. That was the most important thing I think about. They had a deep respect and a deep love for him, mm-hmm. without any sense of slavish or herd mentality or brainwashing or anything. They were all
right.
Highly individual, in one sense, normal people.